Okay, after finish the lesson one, right, we have already know about how to express your idea about the real world problems into the way of either a flowchart or algorithms, right? An algorithm can be displayed or can be written in terms of the natural language, right? That means that the human being can understand about it easily, right? And you can use this algorithm in order to communicate with the can I say the client or the customer, right? So okay, and I just told you that this course is about the problem solving, right? You may have to face or to encounter many problems, right? Real world problems, right? And then you have to change or convert this real world problems into the C programs, right? So before you will go, before you will know about how to write C programming, you will have first understand about the C constructs, okay, in this lesson. So in the lesson two, right, you may have to know about this one, right? I will give you some introduction about the C construct, and then I will start from the character set, and then what does it mean by token, and how can we discriminate between the keywords and identifier and variables that the user defined that variables. And then we also have to know how to define a constant in C programming. Okay, that's all about this in this lesson two, right? Okay, so first of all, I would like to start from the introduction. Every language has a set of symbols, right? Set of symbols, right? For example, English language, right? We have the symbol A to Z, right? A to Z, right? And then we can also use it to create words or token. So in this course, right, we will talk about instead of using the words, right? We use the term token. We call token. These tokens are used to create the statement. We combine tokens, many tokens, in order to form the statement. For example, if some example of the statement is an assignment statement, right? You have already seen sum is equal to x plus y, right? This is an example of a statement, right? And in this one, sum is a token, x is also token, this one is token, and y is also token, right? A statement is a meaningful dialogue that will be used to create a program, right? We combine many statements into the programs. I can say that program is a set of statements. Every programming language like C program has a set of characters that are used to create tokens, which are used to create meaningful statements. Okay, we will combine the characters or the symbol into the token, and we combine tokens right into the statement. And this statement will form a program, right? Note that certain rules are being followed to create tokens and compose statements using this token. The rule can be called syntax or grammar. Okay, after this, right, if you know about the tokens in C, right, the next thing that you have to know that is a rule or the syntax. The syntax rule we can call grammar or syntax. Okay, in order to form the statement and the programs. Okay. The next topic is character set, right? Character set of C comprises of wide range of symbols that can be used to create tokens. Okay. From the set of characters, right? It can be classified into letters, A to Z, right? Letters, digits, white space, and spatial characters. letters will be the uppercase and lowercase. In C programming, we will separate uppercase and lowercase, right? They are not the same. And then digits, right? Starting from 0 to 9. And then white space. White space means the blank space or the tab or carriage return or line feed. Maybe you know about the blank space, right? When you just place the space, right? The blank space, right? This is a space. And the tab, you can use tab, right? On the right hand side button, right? Called tab, right? And tab will be like more than one space. Blank space will just only correct one character, and tab also one character as well. But the indent will be longer longer than the one blank space. Carriage returns means to. Okay, so when you write A, B, C, D, E, something like the F, like this, right? Carriage return means to move the current cursor. Normally when you write a program, right, and then your cursor will be here, right? Carriage return means to move the cursor to the first character of that line, like this. Carriage return means like this. And line feed means next line. To move the cursor to the next line. This is line feed. Sometimes line feed will be line feed like this. If you want to move cursor to here, right? You may have to mix two character to mix between carriage return. Carriage return means to move this to this, and line feed is to move this to the next line. So in this case, like, carriage return means move to the first character of the line. But line feed means to go to next line. Go to next line. This is a line feed. Okay. In depth, these four classes are different character. Okay. If you want to go into detail, if you want to know into detail about this one, okay, I will tell you here. For each character, if you have the ASCII code, right? For blank space, the ASCII code is 32. Tab is 7, I'm not sure. Carriage return 30, and line feed will be 10, right? They are different ASCII code. But if you you don't know about this, or this is to go into details about the character set, skip it. But for someone, right, who are very expert in C programming, right, I just want to note it here that they are different characters or different ASCII code. I'm going to talk about the ASCII code again soon. Okay, so now we have letters, digits, special character, white space, right, you know that. And how about special characters, right? Special characters can be like this, right? Can be shown in this table. Comma, period is full stop. Semicolon, this one is called semicolon. Semicolon is very useful, right? The semicolon will be separate statement. Normally we'll use the semicolon in order to show the end of the statement. For example, sum is equal to x plus y. If I want to stop this statement, we use semicolon. Semicolon will be like this. Colon is double like this, colon. Question mark, you have known that. Apostrophe, quotation mark is the double quote. Exclamation mark is not in C programming vertical bar slash backslash tilde underscore dollar sign percent sign caret ampersand pound sign or number sign right we can also have the asterisk right asterisk will be used for the multiplication or multiply symbol okay and slash will be divide and percent sign will use for modulo I will tell you about this again in the operation arithmetic operation for C programming okay these are the list of arithmetic operation minus sign plus sign right less than and greater than right right parenthesis left parenthesis bracket right bracket we will use bracket for array we are going to talk about an array in the last lesson of the first module okay and then we also have the braces right okay these are special characters right you have to remember about this right because they are very useful you can use it in the C programming okay here we are here we go to the next important definition right as I just told you that when we have the characters and then we have to form the characters into a token or a word in C programming but in C programming the smallest unit of a program is called token are created using C character set right we can combine character set all together except what special character right and also we cannot use white space to form the token as well token will be used to delimit each other each token right it's the same as the English language right we will separate two words by using space or white space for example if I program right integer number right so you cannot see this white space but actually it is white space character 32 okay number and then semicolon so in this case like we have to subdivide this statement into token int token number and token semicolon right delimited by blank space in this case blank space is character 32 right this is white space right we can also use tab right we can also use tab and we can also use carriage return or line feed okay in order to delimit or to make the space between the token for C programming you need to know the programmer need to know the syntax rule syntax rule is very important because you need to know about that to form the meaningful programs C programs right the syntax rule of C language dictates how to create token in C and how to use this token to create meaningful statement okay you need to use the syntax rule that is what we are going to study in this course right we have to study about the syntax rule of C language for token right token can be classified or can be divided into five categories right C token can be a keyword, identifier, constant, special symbol, and operators, right? These are the five kinds of token in C, right? We have to start from the first one, that is a keyword. There are 32 keywords in C programming that you have to memorize or recognize. Why do we have to recognize a keyword? The keyword will be the things or the token that you cannot name it as your user-defined variable. Keyword will be used. Keyword, actually it is a token or word that are meaningful, that are that whose meaning are already defined in C language, so you cannot change it. So it needs to be carefully used, right? Similar in C language, right? Some tokens are reserved as a keyword and have some predefined meaning. And this keyword serves as the basic building block for programming statements. Okay, I'll just tell you that there are 32 keywords in C, right? They are listed here. Auto, double, int. These are, I will show you, these are, okay, these are the data type. Double integer, long, character, float. Okay, these are the data type, and the green one will be the C construct. For example, break, if else, right? Case, return, right? Continue, for loop, go to, default, do, if, why, right? Why will be the special data type, right? Maybe I will have to write like this. Short is also the data type. Mm-hmm. Switch is also the keywords. Okay, you have to memorize these 32 keywords, and you cannot name it as your user defined variables. So you have to be careful. Mm-hmm. These are keywords. Okay, except these 32 keywords, you can name your token or your variables, and the name that is a user defined variables can be called identifier. User identifier is user defined name or variable. Programmer can name it himself or herself variables, and we can call it identifier. Identifier, so it is a user-defined token used to name variables or function. For example, integer number or function will be return float text function like this. Okay, this is a user defined, or we can call identifier. An identifier consists of letters, digit, underscore can be also used. Okay, and this is a rule. The first character of an identifier should be a letter. Must be a letter or underscore. Digit is not allowed to be the first character of identifier. And one important thing is that you can have the length of this identifier as much as you can, but traditionally you have to define the number or the length of the character not greater than 31 characters. And for the identifier in C programming, it is case sensitive. What does it mean by case sensitive? It means that an identifier tests and test like this with capital S, they are different in C programming. C programming or C compiler will treat them differently. We treat them as different two variables, different variables. Okay, understand? Okay, this is called case sensitive. You can note here, case sensitive. Case sensitive is important. Case sensitive means the capital letter or the lower letter are sensitive. That's why we call case sensitive. Okay, the next slide will be, I will show you the valid and invalid name, right? First name, the first one is invalid or valid. Valid, right? Because it starts with the letter, right? And also we can have underscore is possible. Excerpt is not identifiable because it is a keyword, if you could remember. Money and dollar sign. No, this is not an identifier because only alphabet, digit, and underscore are valid. Dollar sign is a special character. Excerpt name, excerpt underscore name. Yes. First name. No, because no space is allowed. If you have space, right? Space is character number 32, right? But it will evaluate as two tokens. What's that name? Okay, so you have to be careful about how to name. How to define or declare a variable. Okay. The next one is a constant. In C language, right, we can also define a constant, the constant. And there are five kinds of constants in C programming, right? What does it mean by constant? Constant means a variable. Whose value is fixed and cannot be changed during the execution of a program, right? So we can have five types, right? Integer, real character, string, backslash, right? We'll start from integer, right? This constant refers to the digits, right? Integer. In C program, you can write three kinds of integer. The first one is decimal, value 1, 2, 3, 4. Like this is an example of decimal. But if you want to show hexadecimal or the number base 16, the number base 16, you have to use 0x in front of the number. For hexadecimal, there are 16 character, right? 16 digits, I would say digits, right? 0, 1, 2, 3, 4, 5, 6, 7, 8, 9, A, B, C, D, E, F, right? 16 digits. So it needs to start with 0x in order to determine that it is a hexadecimal. And for the two will be hexadecimal number. And for the octal, octal is similar to the hexadecimal, but it is the number base eight. So base eight, you will have the digit as from 0, 1, 2, 3, 4, 5, 6, and 7. Okay, you can just simply start with 0. So the number or the constant, integer constant, starting with 0, it will be an octal number. Okay, do you understand that? Okay, so you can refer or you can write the number in three forms, decimal, hexadecimal, and octal. Okay, I will. This one is equal to 1 raised to the power 3 plus 2 raised to the power 2 plus 3, 10 raised to the power 1 plus 4, right? This is the decimal. But so this one will be 4 multiplied by 16. It's just to remind you about how to convert into the decimal. This one is hexadecimal. d multiplied by 16 plus 2, right? But d is what? A is equal to 10, b 11, c 12, d 13, right? So this is 13 multiplied by 16. D, E, F, F, G. Okay, this is an octadecimal. Okay, a hexadecimal. How about octal? Octal means 0, 2, 3, 2, 2. This will be 2, 8 raised to the power 3 plus 3 raised to the power 2 plus 2 raised to the 8 raised to the power 1 plus 2. Right, this is how to convert from octal into the decimal. How to convert from hexadecimal into the decimal. Okay. This lesson you have already started from high school. Okay, this is an integer constant. How about the real one? Okay, if you could remember, if you want to define the real number or the real constant, it can be defined or it can be called in terms of the real number or floating point numbers, right? So the example of this one is 12.34, and it can be written in terms of the scientific notation, that is 1, 2, 3, 4 e raised to the power 1, 2, 3, 4 multiplied by 3 raised to the power minus 2, right? Right, this equal to 1, 2, 3, 4 multiplied by 10 raised to the power minus 2. We can see that this one is the mantissa, right? This is the name of the term, right? And this one is the exponential term. Okay, you could remember when you studied, I'm not sure, in the physics course, right, that how can we define this one. And you can also remember about avocado number, right, 6.02 raised to the power 10 raised to the power 23, right. This one is mantissa, and this one is exponential form. Okay, so there are two kinds of the represent of the real number, the real representation. This one in decimal number or the in the scientific number. Decimal or scientific number or notation. But in C program, you can write it like this. For this one, you can write 1, 2, 3, 4, e minus 2. And for avocado number, we will write 0.02e23. Like this. This is the way that we will write a program in C. If you want to write the real constant, okay, can I go to the next slide. Character. If you want to write a character, you can write in the single quote, pair of single quote. For example, W, you can write in like the simple the single quote. or seven. If you want to write a character seven, you can write single quote seven. Otherwise, if you write just only seven, it will be the number, the integer constant, or 7.0, it will be real constant. For character constant, you have to refer to the standard, what we call ASCII code. I've just talked about this before, right? ASCII code, ASCII stands for American Standard Code for Information Interchange, right? I've just told you about the character, right? The character we have its own, a character we have its own ASCII code. For example, I've talked about the space, white space, like 32 space. Can you see? Kelly has returned. Kelly has returned 13, right? Kelly has returned. And 10 will be live feed, right? And tap. Where is the tap? Seven is bell. I cannot find a tab. You can see that for the character A, character capital A, the ASCII code is 65. You may have to remember character A is equal to 65. Character small a is 97. And it's important, 40. Character 0 is 48. Right. These three special or these three character you may need to memorize the ASCII code, right? It can be useful. Because if you could remember just capital A 65, you can guess that, right? You can guess capital Z. Because 65 plus 27 will be 65 plus 26 is 91 minus 1 is 90. Okay. You can calculate for the other characters if you can, and you memorize the first character, right? Capital A is 65. Small letter A is 97. Something like that. Mm-hmm. Okay. This is a ASCII table. And when we have a character, right, we also have the string constant, right? A character, you can use a single quote, but for string, you can use double quote, like hello world, right? Hello world, but you need double quote like this in order to show that is a string constant. Once again, double quote 1, 2, 3, this one is a string constant, but this one is an integer constant. Backslash constant. Sometimes it is a special character can be used in C programming because sometimes you cannot use this special character directly. You need to use it with the special character backslash. For example, if you want to show backslash, you need to use double backslash in order to show one backslash. For example, when I use backslash AB, backslash CD, something like this, but this one is not understandable. In C programming, you need to write AB, right? and \\ in order to show there is one \\ and cd, right? This is one important things of using \. Sometimes this \ you call a escape sequence, right? I will show you the \ constant. Like if you want to make a sound like a bell, right? You can alert by using a character bell, right? \a. If you do ding and \, this one is \. If you want to put form field, you can use \f. And if you want to use new line, sometimes when you write a program print f, right? If you want to print hello, and you want to show the next sentence in a new line, you have to use \n, and then print f will, right? And it will show you hello and can it return, right? Will like this, and then cursor will be here. The current cursor will be here. Okay, this is a way of how to use the \. And you also have many kinds of \. For example, can it return only horizontal tab, horizontal vertical tab, \ itself, question mark, single quote and double quote character, right? You need to use the \ in order to make it as the escape sequence. Mm-hmm. Or you want to put a special character onto the screen. Okay, you have to make a use of \. And the last one will be the variable, right? This is the last topic of this lesson. That is the variables. When we want to write a program, right, we need to store some important data or some in your storage, right? So you need to store or you need to declare a variable name, right? So a variable represents some memory location in physical memory that we use to store some value. That is the meaning of the variable. We can sometimes use it like this. Suppose I want to use x, right? I will write like this. The rectangular will represent the memory, right? And y will be like this, and sum will be like this. Suppose x is 20, y is 30, right? If I want to write a program sum is equal to x plus y semicolon, right? I have to add 20 and 30 into and keep into place, and then store this one into sum, right? This one you call this one to finish x plus y and then store into sum, right? Into the memory, right? Unlike constants, a variable may take different value at during time, during execution, right? So constant cannot be changed, but a variable can be changed during the execution, during the compiling, during the execution time, right? So it means that the value inside or within a variable can be changed all the time, right? Because the name is variable. Variable means it's vary, right? It's different to the constant. A variable name is an identifier. Yes, it's an identifier token, right? That follow the syntax. Syntax is important, syntax rule, right? For creating our identifier. Yeah. However, programmers choose variable name in such way so as to reflect its function or nature. Okay, once again, very important, right? When you write a program in this course, right, or other course, right, you have to name it carefully according to its function. For example, if I want to sum it, you can declare sum, right? as its meaning or as its function. Okay, don't use. Okay, I normally say like integer x, y, z, I, j, k, right? And then do x is equal to y plus z. This is not okay, right? In this course, you have to name it carefully, right? To reflect its function, okay? Sum I, j, k, or some short identifier is also allowed, but you cannot use them. Only one character variable all the way in your programming. Okay, you have to name it as its function or as it the nature of the program. This is important. This the reason is that if you have write your own program, but if you come back again three months later, right, you don't understand at all about what you are trying to do in your program. Or even if you transfer your program to the next programmers, right? The next programmer, other programmer will not know about what are you going to do. Okay, so this is important. So that's all for the lesson two. And I will give you a break for 10 minutes and then we will come back again at 11:55 and then we will continue with the variable and data types in the next lesson. Okay.